and noiseless. For useless, you will see that it depends on the mutual information. Okay, now the mutual information. I have x comma y is equal to I x y denotation is from mutual information. This is equal to h of x minus h of x by y minus h of x by y. H of x is nothing but uncertainty of the input without knowing the output. H of x by y is nothing but uncertainty of the input after observing the output. Okay, after observing the output, what is the meaning of this one? Thus, uncertainty about the input resolved. Okay, this is h of x is nothing but uncertainty about the input without knowing the output. Uncertainty about the input after knowing the output. This y is already occurred. Okay, uncertainty about the input after knowing the output. Uncertainty of the input before knowing the output. Okay, information number. This uncertainty about the input resolved. Uncertainty about the input is resolved. Don't bother about this one. So I have x by input h of x minus h of x by y, and this is equal to h of y minus h of y by x minus h of y by x, and this value can be represented as h of x plus h of y minus h of x comma y. I am for mutual information. I x comma y is equal to h of x minus h of x by y. And this is equal to h of y minus h of y by x. And this is equal to h of x plus h of y minus h of x comma y. Minus h of x comma y. Nothing is there. H of x by y equal to what we are having? H of x by y equal to h of x comma y minus h of y only. We are having h of x comma y is equal to h of x plus h of y by x in this one. So see, h of y by x is equal to h of x by minus h of x. If you substitute here, what you will get? H of x plus h of y minus h of x comma y. In that another formula you are having, which is called h of y plus h of x by y. If you put in place the first one, you will get this one only. H of x plus h of y minus h of x comma y. Nothing is there. This h of x minus h of x by y, nothing but mutual information. The definition point of view, the mutual information is equal to the uncertainty about the channel input. That is resolved by observing the channel output. Uncertainty about the channel input that is resolving by observing the channel output. That is resolving by observing the channel output. Earlier we are having the uncertainty about the channel input is equal to h of x. Okay, which is to be resolved on observing the output. What is uncertainty about the channel input or observing the output? H of x by y. When it will be resolved? H of x minus h of x by y. This is your mutual information. Now, I am writing in the different way. What is this h of x you are having? Minus p of xi log p of xi minus sigma p of xi yj log xi by yj. I am writing this p of xi equal to sigma I j p of xi yj. Why I am writing already we have seen. Okay, into p of xi, this is minus plus here, plus sigma p of xi yj, this minus, and this h of x by having one more minus. Okay, minus plus, this equal to log of p of xi by yj. Now, this by taking this as a common, this sigma I sigma j p of xi yj, by taking this as a common, we can write this value equal to log of p of xi by yj upon p of xi. This is your mutual information. If this x and y are independent, what is the mutual information? We can write this equal to j and p of xi yj log of P of xi by yi can be represented as P of xi into P of yj upon P of xi into P of yj. This is P of yj, this term. P of x comma y divided by P of y. Okay, if these two are independent, so I have separated this one. P of xi into P of yj get cancelled, and this value equal to log 1, this value equal to 0. So whenever this x and y are independent, then mutual information is equal to 0. Whenever this x and y are independent, the mutual information is equal to 0. Mutual information equal to 0. Not only from this one, here also you may get. What is this h of x by y? This h of x by y is equal to simply minus P of xi yi log of xi by yj. Log of P of xi by yj. So this value is equal to simply we can represent P of xi into log of P of xi into yj. P of xi into P of yj divided by P of yj. This get cancelled and this value equal to your h of x only. This value equal to h of x only. So h of x minus h of x equal to 0. Xy equal to h of x minus h of x is equal to 0. Okay, this information theory nothing is there, but we have to go very slowly. Only what is the information behind this? Get it, that's it. Nothing is there. Okay, h of x by information is equal to 0. Since if these are independent, we can say this h of x by y equal to h of x only. If they are independent, h of y by x equal to h of y only. H of y minus h of y equal to 0. So, or otherwise you can say like this also. Okay, if this x and y are independent, indirectly they may give you some information. The x is having some mean, some variance. Y is having some mean, some variance. And this x and y are independent. What is the mutual information between x and y? Okay, at that situation, the corresponding, without having any information, whenever you see the x and y are independent, the corresponding mutual information is equal to 0 only. Whenever the mutual information is equal to 0, the corresponding channel is called useless channel. Some channel is having some information, mutual information I have x comma y. The channel capacity is given by CS is equal to maximum of mutual information. This mutual information thing, what are the units of this mutual information? Which equal to bits per symbol. Entropy only. Entropy equal to bits per symbol. So the units of this one equal to maximum of mutual information of x comma y. Bits per symbol. If you represent with the ready to white Gaussian noise channel, then the corresponding is equal to 1 by 2 log of 1 plus s by n. 1 by 2 log of 1 plus s by n. Bits per symbol. If the input signal is having the bandwidth is equal to b, then the corresponding sampling frequency is equal to 2 into b, right? The corresponding sampling frequency is equal to 2 into b. Now the corresponding information rate, information channel capacitor, information rate in comma is equal to this CS into the sampling frequency f. Which is equal to 1 by 2 log of 1 plus s by n multiply with 2b bits per second, that was. So this is equal to b log 1 plus s by n to the base 2 bits per second, which is called your channel capacity. Channel capacity equal to the maximum of the mutual information. The what you will get is in the bits per symbol. Okay, if that bits per symbol is multiplied with your sampling frequency. That is this much of samples per second. Bits per sample multiply with this sampling frequency, which is equal to 2 into b. Because b is the bandwidth of this channel, the corresponding sampling frequency is equal to 2 into b. So from this, the corresponding channel capacity is equal to b log 1 plus s by n to the base 2. And this process is also plus very, very important role. The channel capacity equal to maximum of the mutual information. What is the mutual information? We will see. What it will be for binary symmetric channel, we will see. Okay. CS. Now, for deterministic channel, first one. For lossless channel, having M symbols, M input symbols and N output symbols, then what is the channel capacity for the lossless channel? If the channel is having your DMS, channel is what? DMS, discrete memory less source, is having X input symbols, sorry, M input symbols and N output symbol, that input means the transmitter. Output is nothing but receiver type, receiver side, N output symbol. Then what is the channel capacity if it is a deterministic, first one is a lossless channel. If it is the lossless channel, channel capacity equal to simply maximum of mutual information. Maximum of mutual information. What we are having here, the maximum of mutual information is equal to, what is the mutual information? This is equal to h of x minus h of x by y. For this lossless channel, what is the value of h of x by y? Already we have seen, which is equal to 0. H of x by y equal to 0. Already we have seen. So this value is equal to your h of x maximum. What is this maximum value of this entropy? This is equal to simply log m to the base 2. The maximum value of this entropy is equal to log m to the base 2 only. So the channel capacity for this lossless channel is log m to the base 2. Now similarly for the deterministic channel, what it will be? Simply this is equal to maximum of the mutual information. This is equal to h of y minus h of y by x. H of y by x is equal to 0 for the deterministic channel. So this is equal to h of y maximum. What will be the maximum value? This is simply log n to the base 2. All of one more questions. Okay, this is simply log n to the base 2. And for the noiseless channel, means it is both lossless and deterministic. H of x by y equal to 0 and h of y by x equal to 0. For this, the corresponding is equal to simply h of x, which is equal to h of y, which is equal to log m to the base 2, which is equal to log n to the base 2. So m is equal to n. For the noiseless channel, m is equal to n. Already we have seen. Okay. For each and every input, there is an output. For the lossless channel, already we have seen the shape. Okay. Already we have seen. This is equal to like this. For m is equal to n and the corresponding channel capacity equal to log m to the base 2. Now, binary symmetric channel, BSC. Binary symmetric channel. What is the channel capacity of the binary symmetric channel? Binary symmetric channel means a channel with an equal transition process, the symmetric transition probability. X1. X2, Y1, Y2, channel with equal transition probability. Equal transition probability is your binary symmetric channel. So here is equal to 1 minus P and here is equal to 1 minus P. Okay, here is equal to 1 minus P. What is the channel capacity of this one? Channel capacity equal to simply maximum of mutual information. This is equal to H of X. I am considering this formula, H of X minus H of X by Y. So this value equal to maximum of this one. Now what is this mutual information? We will see first of all. H of x minus h of x by y. H of x by y equal to simply minus log p of xi yj. Listen how I am writing. Reasoning is enough. No need to do any practice. This is equal to log p of xi by yj. X by y, xi by yj. Don't confuse. P of xi by yj. Now, this value equal to simply in expansion format is equal to minus P of x1 y1 log of P of x1 by y1. Better to consider h of y by x. H of x by also we can write. Okay. H of y by x I am considering. Yj by xi. This is y1 by x1. Means x1 by y1, some calculation is required. Okay, y1 by x1 minus p of x1 y2 log of p of y2 by x1 minus p of x2 y1 log p of y1 by x2 minus p of x2 y2 log p of y2 by x2. What is this value? P of x1 y1. P of x1 y1 is from the joint matrix. From the joint matrix equal to P of x1 multiply with, if you consider P of x1 equal to alpha, or this equal to 1 minus alpha. P of x1 multiply P of x1 multiply with y1 by x1. Right. So this equal to alpha into 1 minus P log of, what is P of y1 by x1? 1 minus P minus my this equal to minus, what about this one? X1 y2 alpha into P minus alpha P log of P minus x2 y1. 1 minus alpha into P. 1 minus alpha into P log of P minus 1 minus alpha into 1 minus P log of 1 minus P log of y2 by x2 log of 1 minus P. This is your what is this? H of y minus h of y by x. H of y by x. So the corresponding mutual information here is equal to h of y plus alpha into 1 minus p into log of 1 minus p plus alpha p log of p plus 1 minus alpha into p of log of p plus 1 minus alpha into 1 minus p into log of 1 minus p. Log of 1 minus p. This is your mutual information. Okay. When it will be maximum? Whenever this term h of y is maximum, whenever this term h of y is maximum, h of y is maximum, this h of y is maximum, the mutual information will be maximum, which is your corresponding channel capacity, which is your corresponding channel capacity. At what condition this will be maximum? H of y maximum equal to what? How many symbols are there here? Two symbols. Two symbols are there. Two symbols are there. At what condition this will be maximum? This will be maximum equal to log 2 equal problem. This log 2 to the base 2 is equal to 1. Okay, which is equal to 1. So the corresponding channel capacity equal to 1 plus alpha of 1 minus p log 1 minus this total. 1 plus this total. This is your corresponding channel capacity. If you consider this alpha is equal to, this symbols are of equiprobable. If alpha is equal to 1 by 2 and 1 minus alpha equal to 1 by 2, then what it will be? If alpha is equal to 1 by 2, and this 1 minus alpha also 1 by 2. So we can write these two are the common, and we can consider 1 minus p into log of 1 minus p as the common. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is equal to 1. So this is equal to 1 minus p log of 1 minus p plus, and this one alpha equal to 1 by 2 here and 1 minus alpha equal to 1 by 2 here. By taking this p log p as a common, plus p log p into 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. In what case is one? If alpha is equal to 1 by 2, if the symbols are of equiprobable, in this case, the corresponding channel capacity is equal to, directly you can write p log p plus 1 minus p log 1 minus p. If these two are of the equiprobable, the symbols x1 and x2 are of the equiprobable, then the corresponding channel capacity is equal to 1 plus p log p plus 1 minus p log 1 minus p, bits per symbol. Okay, bits per symbol it is. Information means bits per symbol. Magic information, bits per symbol. Okay, right. This is equal to p log p, CS we can call. 1 minus p log 1 minus p, and general case is equal to this one. Alpha 1 minus p, 1 minus alpha, like this. Okay, now you to remember, if I ask you, simply calculate h of y by x. Or h of x by y, better h of y by x. Okay, better h of y by x. Or h of y, if these are not equal, if these are, what you are saying, not unequal, okay, not equal probable, means this is something value, this is something value, you have to be calculated separately. If the x1 and x2 are equiprobable, directly you can use this one. Okay, p log p plus 1 minus p log 1 minus p log 1 minus p, otherwise you are not eligible to use this one. You have to calculate separately. You have to calculate separately. Now, write down your question. For the given figure, what is P of Z1 and P of Z2? X1, X2, 0.9, 0.8, 0.1, 0.2. This is your y1, this is your y2. 0.1, 0.2. This is your z1, this is your z2. This value is 0.9 and 0.8. What are the given figure? P of z1 is equal to how much? And P of z2 equal to how much? For that, what it requires? P of y1 and P of y2 are required first of all. P of y1 and P of x1 they have given equal to 0.5. This is equal to 0.5. Equal problem. P of x1 they have given 0.5 and P of x2 they have given 0.5. They are asking what is the P of z1 and P of z2. Okay? That thing. Ready for me? Chalo me. No, good for joint matrix. X1, X2, Y1, Y2. X and Y1 nothing but 0.5 multiply with 0.9. Multiply 0.9 is equal to 0.45. 0.5 multiply with 0.1. 0.05. X2 for this one. 0.5 multiply with 0.2. 0.1. And 0.5 multiply with 0.8. 0.4. 0.4. So from this 0, Y1 is equal to 0.55 and y2 is equal to 0.45. So this P of y1 is equal to 0.55 and this is equal to 0.45. So this value is equal to 0.55 and P of y2 is equal to 0.45. From that we can write the joint matrix for this one. So this is equal to y1, y2, z1, z2. y1, y2, z1, z2. y1, z1 means 0.55 multiplied with 0.9 into 0.9. This 0.55 multiply with 0.1. 0.1. 0.45 multiply with 0.2. 0.45 multiply with 0.8. Already we have done, nothing is there, just for revision only. From this, P of z1 nothing but this addition. And P of z2 is nothing but that addition. Now finally we will get equal to 0.585. And this value equal to 0.415. This is your P of z1. And this is your P of z2. Okay? Simple question. This type of simple question they are asking. Right. Next one. Given. AWGN channel, given AWGN channel with a bandwidth of 4 kHz, with a bandwidth of 4 kHz and the PSD 10 to the power minus 12 watt per hedge. AWGN channel with a bandwidth of 4 kHz and the PSD is 10 to the power minus 12 watt per hedge. Signal power is of 0.1 milliwatt. Signal power is of 0.1 milliwatt. Calculate the channel capacity. Calculate the channel capacity in bits per second. Calculate the channel capacity in bits per second. Okay, nothing is there. Simply C equal to B log 1 plus S by N to the base 2. C is equal to B log 1 plus S by N to the base 2. Channel bandwidth B is available. Signal power is available and the noise power is also available. Noise power is equal to simply N0 into W. Here we are having this capacity equal to B log 1 plus S by N to the base 2. B what they have given? 4 kilohertz. 4 into 10 cube. Log of signal power equal to 0.1 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by noise power. Noise power is equal to your N0 into W. What is your N0? n naught by 2 they have given, the PhD they have given is equal to 10 to the power minus 12 watt for H. Watt for H, from this L naught is equal to 2 into and the corresponding bandwidth substitution, we will get the corresponding value. Here the base is equal to 2. Okay, while doing the calculation, we have to consider the corresponding base is equal to 2. Okay, in examination, you may take directly log 10. Okay, you may get the wrong answer. Now, what is the channel capacity? What is the channel capacity? The channel bandwidth is infinity. Next one, what is the channel capacity? If the channel bandwidth is infinity, C equal to limit B tending to infinity, B log 1 plus S by N to the base 2. So this value equal to simply limit B tending to infinity log of 1 plus S by N naught into B, and I suppose is equal to N naught into B whole to the power B. All to the power B, as we are having limit x tends to infinity 1 plus 1 by x all to the power x is equal to e. 1 plus 1 by x all to the power x is equal to e. So here B tending to infinity, we have to represent in this format B tending to infinity into S by N naught into B tending to infinity. This value equal to log of 1 plus S by N naught B. This term in the reverse you need to get. We need to what? So this is equal to N naught into B divided by S naught into S by N naught 1 by X and X. Here S by N naught B, N naught B by S. So this can be represented as, this can be represented as log of E to the power S by N naught, E to the power S by N naught, and this value is equal to log E into S by N naught. This is equal to log e to the base 2, log 2 to the base e, s by n naught, this is equal to 1 by ln of 2, s by n naught, this is equal to 1.44, s by n naught. We may be much more familiar with this 1.44 s by n naught. In options, they may give you 1 by ln of 2, 1 by ln of 2 into s by n naught in first option, 1.44 s by n naught in the second option, in the third option, both A and B. Okay, both A and B. So 1 by ln 2 into S by N naught. From this only you got 1.44 S by N naught. Okay, 1.44 S by N naught. So as B tending to infinity, the corresponding channel capacity is equal to 1.44 into S by N naught BPS, bits per second. Okay, here what is this N naught? In this formula, B log 1 plus S by N. This N is your noise power. Okay, this N is noise power and this N naught is your PSD. Post vector energy, don't be confused. Here this S by N is not, this SC signal power only. Okay, SC signal power only. Here the ratio N naught is your PSD. Here this SC is your signal power and this N is your noise power. N is your noise power. This is the area. For the occurrence of the mistakes in the examination. Okay, you may take directly S by N ratio. Okay, this N naught is either for two side PSD or one side PSD. One side PSD also power equal to N naught W only. For two side PLC also power equal to N naught W only. Okay, getting or not? If two side PSD, the value of N naught may be changes. One side PSD, the value of N naught may be changes depending on this. In the previous question, two side PSD they have given 10 to the power minus 12 and N naught is equal to 2 into 10 to the power minus 12. So one side PSD they have given N naught is equal to 10 to the power minus 12 only. The power point of N naught value, N naught value only. Okay, they mentioned two side PSD or one side PSD, whatever. Okay, by corresponding feed and infinity, the channel capacity equal to 1.44 S by N naught BPS. S by N naught BPS. Or we can get this equal to 1 by ln of 2 S by N naught. S by N naught. Now, so the different questions they may ask you. Let us one more question. AWGN telephone channel. AWGN telephone channel has a bandwidth of 4 kHz. And the PSD is 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 5. Watt per H. If the information at the rate of 52 kbps. If the information at the rate of 52 kbps is to be transmitted over this channel, over the channel, which is the small bit error rate. With the small bit error rate, then the minimum bit energy is, minimum bit energy is, here the bandwidth is equal to 4 kilohertz, the two sided PSD equal to 2.5 into 10 to the power, 2.5 into 10 to the power, what I have given? 10 to the power minus 5, 10 to the power minus 5 watt per hertz. And the bit rate is equal to 52 kbps. Bit rate is equal to 52 kbps. And they are asking what is the bit energy. EB is equal to how much? EB is nothing but simply what is your power? Power is equal to EB by TB only. So EB is equal to power into T. But nothing but signal power into TB. If you know the signal power, if you multiply with the TB, if you multiply the signal power, you multiply with the TB, you will get the corresponding, you will get the required bit energy, required bit energy. What they have given? The information rate is equal to 52 kbps. 52 information rate is equal to channel capacity only. So channel capacity always should be greater than or equal to bit rate. Channel capacity should be greater than or equal to bit rate. Then only the channel can transmit the required bit rate, the required bits, okay, the channel capacity. So this can raise, you can say the channel capacity equal to bit rate is equal to B log 1 plus S by N to the base 2. What is your bit rate? 52 into 10 to the power 3 is equal to B 4 into 10 cube log of 1 plus the signal power divided by noise power, N0 into devil, everything is available, N0 is available, devil is available. Everything is available. From this you may get a corresponding S value, and if you multiply, this S with TB is your minimum bit energy, whatever they are asking. Okay, we can get. Okay, whenever you will see the native white Gaussian noise channel along with some bandwidth, some PSDs and some information rate, the point to be striking in our mind is that they are concentrating about the channel capacity. They are concentrating about the channel capacity. Channel capacity equal to B log 1 plus S by N to the base 2. Okay, they may give you for getting this much of signal power, what may be the bandwidth. Okay, directly they may give you the signal power in the, in this question you have calculated the signal power for some bandwidth. Okay, they may give you the signal power in the form of dB, and what is the bandwidth required, what is the minimum bandwidth required to get the required capacity, not maximum bandwidth required, whatever. Okay, something depending on that they may ask you. Okay, you have to calculate the required value. So only the point you have to remember is that if the question is of the AWGN channel and the noise PSDs, and the information rate. The immediate point you have to the point to be striking your mind is that this is concentrating about the B log 1 plus S band to the base 2. Okay, right. Next one. Average code word length. Average code word length L. This average code word length L is equal to sigma P of xi into ni, where ni is the number of bits for representing the symbol. N of ni is the number of bits to represent the symbol. Suppose you are having two symbols P of x1 and one symbol corresponding bits equal to 0 and P of x2 corresponding bits equal to 0, 1. The corresponding L is equal to P of x1 into 1 plus P of x2 into 2, where n is the number of bits. Number of bits to represent the symbol. Okay? Number of bits to represent the symbol. The corresponding is the average code word length. L is equal to sigma P of xi ni, and this efficiency is equal to H of x divided by, and this efficiency is equal to L minimum divided by L. This L minimum, this L is having some condition is that H of X should be, derivation is not required. H of X should be less than or equal to, this should be less than or equal to H of X plus 1. H of X should be less than or equal to, L should be less than or equal to H of X plus 1. This, that is, L should be greater than or equal to H of X. The minimum, L minimum is equal to H of X only. The efficiency of this DMS source is L minimum by L, this is equal to your h of x divided by L, where L is the average cold water length, this one. L is the average cold water length. This L is having the two types of L available for the uniform coding, Shannon Fano coding and Hoffman coding. Uniform coding is nothing but if there are five symbols, how many bits are required to represent? Simply 3 bits. 5 symbols means minimum 2 bits is not enough. 2 square is equal to 4. 2 cube is equal to 8. So it requires 3 symbols. Average cold water length is equal to 3. Average cold water is under the uniform coding. Okay? Under for this calculation of this, two more codes are there, Shannon-Fano coding and the Hoffman coding. How to calculate this Shannon-Fano coding and how to calculate this Hoffman coding, we will see. So you will call, they will call efficiency equal to this one, and redundancy they may ask you. Redundancy equal to 1 minus eta. Redundancy is equal to 1 minus eta. If they ask you the question, if you listen the word, what is the redundancy of this DMSO is equal to 1 minus eta. 1 minus this one, efficiency. Efficiency equal to L minimum by L. This L equal to h of x divided by L. This condition is also very important. The boundaries of this average cold water length, which equal to h of, lower bound and upper bound. What is equal to h of x less than or equal to L less than or equal to h of x plus 1. L less than or equal to h of x plus 1. From this, this efficiency equal to L minimum by L. And this one, we are having two codes, and so I told to you, which is the Shannon coding and Hoffman coding. Shannon-Fano coding they are called. Hoffman coding, and this the most efficient is the Hoffman coding, you have to be remember. The most efficient is the Hoffman coding. What is the efficiency of this DMS? If the most efficient code is used. Most efficient code is equal to Hoffman coding. If Hoffman coding is, what is the efficiency? How to calculate Hoffman coding, you will see, no problem. Okay, Hoffman coding, the question, if they say Hoffman coding or efficient code, most efficient code. We have to consider the corresponding is your Hoffman coding and the Shannon-Fano coding. We are having some ambiguity. So nobody will read this one. Ambiguity means in these calculations we have to separate the given symbols into the two parts. As those are having the almost equal probability as the one group and those are having the unequal probability as the another group. While forming this group, some ambiguity. Somebody will take some different group and somebody will take some different group. So some ambiguity may present on the Shannon-Fano coding. Don't bother about this one. If you get the different answer like that, don't bother about this one. Because we will see in the problem, no problem. While grouping, somebody will take this much as one group and somebody will take the second one as some another group. The intention is that the group is that we have to separate into two groups, those are having the almost equal probabilities. Okay? While deciding the group, some ambiguity may be present in the Shannon-Fano coding. And for the Hoffman coding, there is no such type of ambiguities. So this is the most efficient code. Most efficient code is this Hoffman coding. Okay? Hoffman coding having the more efficiency. Most efficient means they having the more efficiency. Upon uniform coding, Shannon-Fano coding and Hoffman coding, most efficient, highest efficiency is equal to for this one only, Hoffman coding. So most efficient code is even Hoffman coding. In the question, if they ask you what is the efficiency of this DMS source, you are having the highest by using the more efficient code, then you have to go for the Hoffman coding only. How can you draw this Shannon-Fano coding and Hoffman coding? You will see one problem. We will discuss along with one problem. Write down a problem. The DMS codes having the symbols with the probabilities having 5 symbols here. 5 symbols, the corresponding probabilities are 0.4, 5 symbols you are having, okay, probabilities are 0.4, 0.16, 0.19, 0.1, 0.15, 0.15. What is the efficiency? Question is that what is the efficiency by using Shannon-Fano coding and Hoffman coding? For any code, first of all you have to calculate the entropy h of x. If you calculate this entropy of this, so entropy equal to normal procedure. P of xi, log P of xi sigma I. This value equal to 2.15. Entropy equal to 2.15. Now putting Shannon-Fano coding. Shannon manual coding. In this first condition is for Shannon manual coding or Hoffman coding, you have to arrange these probabilities in the decreasing order, highest to the lowest, decreasing order, that is from highest to the lowest. So if you arrange them in the decreasing order, first one is at 0.4 followed by 0.19, 0.16, 0.15 and 0.1 and 0.1. In this you have to separate this into the two parts, though they are almost having the equal probability. Here you are having 0.4, the 0.19 and 0.16 difference is equal to 0.03, here is difference is equal to 0.01, here this difference is equal to 0.05, but this is having the more difference, so you can separate this into the two parts. This is having the 0 and the upper part is equal to 0 and place lower part is equal to 1. Upper part of this is equal to 0 and place this lower part is equal to 0, and after that again repeat the same procedure till the end. We are having only 2, either 0 or 1, till the end of this one. Okay, again I am separating, this is equal to 0.03, so this I am separating, this is equal to 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, and after this, of these two, the difference is equal to 0.01 only. For this one, you are having the more difference. Okay, 0.05 around you are having. 0.5 you are having. So, I am separating again this into the two parts. And here equal to 0.01. Here is equal to 0.01. And finally, these two only remain. These two also separate into the two parts. This is equal to 0. And this value is equal to 1. This value is equal to 1. Like this, you have to do using the Shannon panel coding. This is whole nothing is there. We have to separate into the two parts. As almost equal probability. Here, all are having almost equal probability here. Okay, equal probability here. So, I am separating this into the two parts. First part is equal to 0 and the second part, upper part is 0 and the lower part all are 1s. And after this is over. Okay, and in this one, this is equal to, in this one separating into the two parts equal to 0.03 and this difference equal to 0.01 error. So I am taking this as the two parts. Upper part is 0 and lower part all are 1s. And these two are almost equal. This two is separate. So I am separating this into the two parts. Upper part is 0 and lower part is 1. This lower part is completed. Okay, this is one. And of this one, we are having only 2. So separate this into 0 or 1. Okay, somebody will take you. These two are the equal group and these two are the equal group. Okay, at that situation also we can get. Okay, no problem. So because of this grouping, different persons may take different. So while grouping, some ambiguity may be present while selecting these equal probabilities, while forming these groups. So how many bits are there for this one? 0. For this one? 1, 0. For the second one? For the third one? 1, 1. And for the fourth one? For the third one, this one 1100, and for the fourth one 1101, and for the fifth one 111. 0 10 corresponding bits are 010, 1100, 101, 111. Okay, from this the corresponding code word length is equal to, this is for the corresponding probability here equal to 0.4. The code word length is equal to 0.4 into 1 plus 0.19 into 2 plus 0.16 into 4 plus 0.15 into 4 plus 0.1 into 3 0.1 into 3. Okay, the answer whatever you will get, this value is equal to around 2.32 from this efficiency is equal to entropy 2.15 divided by 2.32 divided by 2.32, something you will get. Okay, 2.15 divided by 2.32. This is the way of forming the Shannon panel coding. Now, go for the Hoffman coding. There will be no ambiguity and this will be very easy. Hoffman coding. Similarly, that case also, first of all, we have to arrange in the decreasing order. You have to arrange the symbols in the decreasing probabilities. Means highest to the lowest. Okay, 0.1, 0.19, 0.16, 0.19. And in this, from the lower part you have to go, this is equal to addition only. It's equal to 0.15 plus 0.1, which is equal to 0.25. Okay, 0.25, again you have to arrange in the decreasing order. So first equal to 0.4, now 0.25, 0.16, 0.15. This is what 0.25. Now, after, 0.25, 0.19, 0.16. 0.4, 0.25, 0.19, 0.26. Okay, again we need to add these two, what you will get? 0.35. 0.35, 0.25, 0.4. It is 0.4, 0.25. Again, you have to follow till the end. Okay, this is 0.35 plus 0.25. What you have? 0.6, 0.6 and 0.4. Now after this, assign one 0 to the first one and 1 to the lower one. 0 to the first one and 1 to the lower one. Okay, 0 to the first one and 1 to the lower one. This 0 is equal to available up to this one also. This one is directly to this 0.4. This one is directly to 0.4. This 0 is to be given to this 0.35 and 0.25. 0.35 and 0.25. And after this, to separate, the upper part is equal to 0 and lower part is equal to 1. Upper part is equal to 0 and lower part is equal to 1. Okay, and this 0.25. This 0.25 can directly given to this 0.25. This 0.1. 0.1 and 0.35 to be given to both 0 0 0 0. Upper part is equal to 0 and lower part is equal to 1. Okay, getting a lot. Upper part is 0 and lower part is equal to 1. Now this 0.1 is directly given to this one. This one is directly given to this one. Now 0 0 0 directly given to this one. This one 0 0 0 and this 0 0 1 directly given to this one 0 0 1. And what about this one? 0 1 can be given to the both. To be given to the both. 0 1. Upper is 0 and lower is 1. Upper is 0 and lower is 1. So 0 1 0 and 0 1 1. So finally we are having for 0.1. For 0.4 it is represented with 1. For 0.19, 0 0 0, 0 0 1, 0 1 0 and 0 1 1. Getting how you got it written? Nothing is there. First of all, represent in the decreasing order. Decreasing order. Okay, first of all, decreasing, represent this in the decreasing order. First, add these two from 0.15 plus 0.1, 0.25. Again, arrange them in the decreasing order. Add these two, 0.35. Again, arrange in the decreasing order. Add these two, 0.6. Again, arrange in the decreasing order. Decreasing order. Whenever you reach this level, okay, give the first one upper part as the 0 and lower part as the 1. As like a Shannon dialogue only. Separate two parts, upper is 0 and lower is 1. Here also, this upper is 0 and lower is 1. So, this 0.4, this one is directly given to this 0.4. Getting or not? This 0, this 0.6 is the combination of 2. So, 0 to be given to the 2. Given to the 2. So, here is 0 and 0. And for the separation, upper is 0 and lower is 1. So, this is 0 and this is 1. This is 1. So 0.25 directly given to this one. But 0.35 is a combination of these two. Okay. So this 0 0 should be given to these two. Okay. 0 0 0 1. But the separation upper is 0 and lower is 1. 0 0 0 0 1. And here also the 0.25 is the combination of these two. Combination of these two. So 0 1 to be given should be given to these two. Okay. 0 1 upper is 0 and lower is 1. Upper is 0 and lower is 1. Getting your point? Right. Now for the average pole wall length, L is equal to 0.4 into 1 plus 0.19 into 3 plus 0.16 into 3 plus 0.15 into 3, the final bits, plus 0.1 into 3. Upon addition, all this you will get 2.2. You will get 2.2. Earlier you got 2.3 something. Okay, 2.32 or 3.35 something you got. Here equal to 2.2. Now from this entropy is equal to simply 2.15 upon 2.2 upon 2.2. Of this, for L, if you consider this as L Hoffman, this L Hoffman is L Shannon Fano. L Shannon Fano. So this value is lower. Lower in the denominator. So efficiency will be higher for this one only. If you use uniform coding, what is this L? L for the uniform coding? Is equal to 3. Since you are having 5 symbols, minimum it requires 3 bits. Getting or not? Minimum it requires 3 bits. So the corresponding L is equal to 3 in the uniform coding. This will be highest value. So the corresponding efficiency will be very lower. Very lower. So the most efficient is your Hoffman coding. So efficiency of this Hoffman coding is most higher. So you can call this Hoffman coding as the most efficient code, and the corresponding, if you have the redundancy in the bits, this is equal to 1 minus efficiency, 1 minus theta. Okay, right, 1 minus theta. The forming of this is Hoffman coding.